Hello friends, this is a sporadic what I got from the local markets. We went to grocery outlet bargain market. We got some things, okay? And before I get into the haul, I just want to say you can use my link down below for cash inbox dollars. It's a website where you can get paid to take surveys, try out apps, send in your grocery receipts. And you can use my link and you can get $5 just by signing up. The first thing I got is this Barbara's shredded wheat. Something I've been loving to do lately is get like one of the squares, cause they're like this big, rip up one of the squares and rip up like a half of another square. Put 3 tablespoons of crunchy almond butter, a little bit of cinnamon, and put a little bit of maple sugar, some plain like almond milk or plain rice milk, and it's so yummy and so good. Oh my gosh. I know, I don't usually eat maple sugar, but I've been getting into this really cool cookbook, and one of the recipes called for maple sugar.
Yeah, I don't advocate you use that on a regular basis.
But if you're in transition from the standard American diet to a macrobiotic lifestyle, I think a little bit of maple sugar is okay if you're not dealing with anything major. Then we got this 2 pounds of organic juicy apples, and they are really yummy. Tom has been loving them for dessert lately. And we also got this pure ground cumin. This is like Tom's favorite spice. He puts it in beans. That's his like secret thing. Oh, we also put it on popcorn, homemade popcorn. We also found this blackberry chia juice, cold pressed. I don't know, we just got it. Has no added sugar, so that's pretty cool. And we also found this Artisana, which I've seen this at Sprouts, raw tahini, sesame seed butter. And it's organic and all that. And we use tahini for so many things. Oh my God, so many things. So yummy. And then we also got this organic broccoli. And I got this organic cauliflower, which you guys might remember me saying that I don't like cauliflower. Yin turns to yang, girl. What you hate becomes what you love, and what you love becomes what you hate. I just had this like craving to make a cauliflower steak, and there's plenty of recipes out there you can look up, but I have Alicia Silverstone's The Kind Life, or The Kind Diet, and she has a cauliflower steak recipe that I've been wanting to try, and I've had cauliflower steak.
So funny, I'm editing a video about everything I ate when I went to Thailand a few years ago.
It's taking forever to upload or to edit because
I'm just not always in the mood to edit.
That's why you'll see me upload like every day for like 2 weeks, and then you'll just hear nothing from me for like a month. And I got organic baby kale. They don't always have at the grocery outlet. Bargain market. It's kind of like the outlet stores, like regular outlet stores. They kind of just sell like overstock or like what doesn't sell at other grocery stores. That's why they can make the prices cheaper. So they don't always have it, but when they do have kale, we get it, because kale is like probably the best green to be eating every single day, girl. Eat your greens daily. And we got these La Tortilla Factory, handmade tortillas, handmade style. It's a blend of yellow corn and wheat, and it's non-GMO. So if you've heard me talk about corn, you know, anytime you get any corn product, make sure it's organic or at least non-GMO, because they really, really mess with corn. And I've been reading a lot more about organic farming and how it used to be versus today, and all the kind of government interference, and just there's so much that happens with our food. And people, don't overwhelm yourself with all this stuff that you hear about food or all these things you know about food. I promote the purest energy, the best, the healthiest food, but at the same time, we can only do the best that we can do, you feel me? So don't feel too pressured to to eat perfectly, because honestly, even if we had the most pure food available to us all the time, we still have our own personal relationships with food, and there's just so much that goes into healthy eating. All we can do is educate ourselves, practice, be gentle with ourselves, and just do the best that we can, okay? Speaking of organic and farming, we're very lucky to have an organic produce store, and they sell some other things. They sell some meats that are from local farmers that are better, you know, they're not factory farmed animal products. They have some miso, some sauerkraut. It's a little store. We got some kale. Again, we eat kale basically every day. We also got some, it looks like, I don't know, a different kind of green. I don't know. Oh, we got daikon. Freshly pulled from the earth. Yeah, we got some daikon radish, which is so good for your intestines. If you're having trouble with your digestion, daikon is so good, especially also too dealing with the virus. Daikon is a pungent taste, and the pungent taste is connected with metal energy, and the organs connected with metal energy are the lungs and the large intestine. So not only does it help you with your digestion, but it helps eliminate mucus from your lungs, which contributes to healthy respiratory function, which is what we're really focusing on, being a six metal year. We got some Meiji tofu, all natural, non-GMO. Once again, soybeans. If you're gonna buy anything with soy, make sure it's organic or at least non-GMO, because they do a lot of crazy stuff with soybeans as well. Don't blindly trust any corn product. Don't blindly trust any soy product. Make sure you know some background on it before you put it in your body, girl. That's it for me.
I wanna thank my patrons for supporting me on my journey. Sign up with the link in the description, and everyone will benefit. Yeah, girl.